have an awesome update to share tonight on the story of Mr. Halloween. He's the guy we told you about last week who spent the last 20 years using his Halloween display to scare up donations for the Farmington Food Shelf. Well, during that story last week, John opened up his heart, explaining why he collects all the food. And after we aired the story, I asked all of you to see if we could help John collect more than he even could imagine. And as Kent will show you, it worked.
On a night when fresh snow gave trick-or-treaters extra reason to shudder.
Happy Halloween!
Mr. Halloween was in his element.
Happy Halloween!
But beyond the tricks and chilling exterior,
you can still go out and get a treat.
This was a hotbed for treats, with candy going out.
Thank you!
And canned good coming in.
I appreciate it. Thank you and happy Halloween.
When we first visited his Farmington home last week.
This is just this year, this month.
Jon Brimacomb was aiming to make his 20th annual collection for the Farmington Food Shelf special.
It's quite impressive. I'm hoping to get 1,000 pounds, which would break all my records.
3 years after the death of his wife, Susie, broke his heart.
She had 5 different cancers, 8 different times, over 18 years. Sorry.
It was Susie who inspired the very first food drive after she was initially diagnosed in 2003. And in 2023, her story.
Thank you.
Inspired more traffic than John could imagine.
This is way past what I was expecting this year. It's just amazing. I figured Susanna's up there working her magic.
And if you're wondering exactly how far his drive would surpass his goal, let's just say it took a while.
Oh, look at that. Isn't that great?
Along with.
Yeah, but it's uphill.
A few extra volunteers.
1,138.
That's fantastic.
Just with trip one.
Yep. I already know there's so much more downstairs that I could be going at 2,000 now.
A ton of food.
Literally.
Yeah.
Yep.
And he would soon come to know that it would add up to a ton of exercise. But it came at a time when the food shelf needs every ounce of help.
Our demand is up so much. Maybe just do like 1, 2.
Like that?
Yeah.
Karen Brownwell says they saw record demand last year.
There we go.
And this year?
Voila. We're seeing, a 25% to 30% increase, I'd say, and families coming in every week.
I organized it by beans and then vegetables.
With need like that, you can't really put a number.
I think this is a light load.
On the value of 2 decades of Halloween deliveries.
It's almost something we've come to plan on or to hope for.
Though to be clear, nobody planned on the hope he was about
close to 2,000
to deliver.
Now, would you believe 3,235 pounds? John!
No matter how you add it up.
That's a ton and a half.
That's enough.
So awesome. Oh.
To give anyone.
This is wonderful.
The chills.
Thank you, guys.
John may have done the heavy lifting.
I know she was pulling strings.
But he certainly didn't do it alone, pulling everyone closer.
And the community just blew me away.
In the process.
We are so thankful, John.
I really
Or do I say Mr. Halloween?
Thank you guys so much.
I'm so thankful for you, John, and for those strings getting pulled. A few more visitors actually left money instead of cans when they went to John's house for Halloween. So after that ton and a half, he gave them $160 at the food shelf. It's awesome stuff.